If you are serious about growing on YouTube, then what you do straight after uploading your video is just as important as your video itself. A lot of creators make the mistake of just uploading their video to YouTube without taking the necessary actions. It is not just enough to upload your videos, but utilizing every necessary detail that YouTube has offered to make your video go viral. And some people do upload their video using the YouTube app. When you click on the plus sign and then you see the video, you see the short, and you also see live, some people just go ahead, click on the video, and then it will just bring out a few things you need to do, and then they upload their video. Also, some people upload their video using the YouTube Studio app. You just click on that plus sign and upload their video straight. Now, uploading your videos using these two apps is not going to give you the opportunity to explore all the essential features that YouTube has provided for you to make your videos go viral. Now, the best way to upload your video on YouTube is through the your browser. Now, you're going to go over to studio.youtube.com. If you are using a laptop, you just go to studio.youtube.com. But if you're using your phone, you can also do the same thing. And type on your browser using the desktop version. Just type on studio.youtube.com, and then it's going to open up to the full features that you can actually utilize to upload your video and make your video go viral. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how you are going to do all of these things step by step. Okay, so if this sounds like something you would love to learn, why not stay with me to the end of this video and watch how I'm going to upload my video and utilize every feature that YouTube has got to offer.
So guys, you go to your browser and you type studio.youtube.com. You're just going to type it, studio.youtube.com. Here, this is what you're going to type. Okay, so I already have my video that I want to set up. I want to publish, okay? But if you don't already, if you have not already uploaded your video, you're just going to come to create. Click on create here. When you click on create, you see upload videos. When you click on upload video, you're just going to click on select file, and it will take you to your gallery straight. From there, you can upload your video. So when you are done uploading your video, you're going to give your video a title and then the description. Okay, I already made a video on how to set up your description and your title. So you can go to my channel to watch this video. This is the video. Go and watch this video on how to set up your description from scratch and your title. Okay, so I'm not going to do that again in this video. So I already have my title and my description set. And then the next thing, you're going to upload your thumbnail. YouTube has given creators the opportunity to upload more than one thumbnail in order to test run which thumbnail will sell out your video the most. Okay, so you're just going to upload your thumbnail. So for this video, I'm going to be uploading two thumbnails. I'm going to test run my video with two thumbnails. So you're going to click on test and compare. This is where you click on. If you want to upload more than one thumbnail, don't just click on upload file. You're going to click on test and compare. Okay. And then you're going to click on it. Then you click on the first box and wait for it to take you to your gallery. Okay. So I'm uploading the first one. Then I can go ahead and upload the second thumbnail that I want. So this is my second thumbnail. So all right, so when that is done, you're just going to click on done. And test is going to, and YouTube is going to test run both thumbnails. All right, now moving on, the next thing you're going to do is to come and add your playlist. This is very important when uploading your video. Make sure you add playlist to this video. So I'm going to click on playlist. Then you can see I'm going to add Canva tutorial, general tutorials. Then I'm just going to add one more. Silent live stream. I'm going to add it to silent live stream. Okay. I think I'm going to go with this. When you're done selecting your playlist, you're going to click done. And if you don't know how to create a playlist, I uploaded a short video on a while ago on how to create a playlist. It's very simple and easy. So watch that video and learn how to create a playlist from there. Okay. So then the next setting, you say, it says this, your audience, you're going to select your audience. This video is set to not made for kids. Yes. You're going to set your video to not made for kids. Okay, you can see it here. Because the reason is this, if you set your video to not made for kids, the YouTube is going to turn off the comment section. Yes. But if you say no, your comment section will be open to your viewers. And then we're going to go on to the next one. You click on show more. age restriction. Okay, here it says, yes, restrict my video to viewers over 18. No, don't restrict my videos to viewers over 18 only. Okay, yes, you're going to click no. Then, if your video has paid promotion, maybe you were paying to promote a product or something, so you're going to click on this box here. But if your video does not have a paid promotion, you're going to unclick it. Now here it says altered content. Do any of the following describe your content? And the first one says makes a real person appear to say or do what they didn't say or do. Alters footage of a real event or place. Generate a realistic looking scene that didn't actually occur. So if your video carries any of these three, you're going to click yes. But if it doesn't, you're going to click no. Most of the time, these type of other altered contents are AI generated contents. So my video does not have anything like that. So I'm just going to click no. Okay, then automatic chapters, allow automatic chapter and key moments. Yes, you're going to tick this box. Featured places, you're going to tick this box as well. Allow automatic concept, you're going to tick this box as well. Now your tags, you're going to include tags on your video. You're going to include tags from here. So if you don't have the tags you want to include or you don't have any in mind at the moment, all you're going to do, go back to your description. You know, I already explained how you can create your description, how to get a very good description. So you'll go back to your description. You're going to copy some of the hashtags here. Okay. You're going to copy some of your hashtag in your description. Okay. So I've selected some of the hashtags and then I'm going to copy it. When you copy, just come down to the bottom of your description here. So you're going to paste your copied hashtags at the bottom of your description. Now, the reason is this. We're going to cut it back and paste in our tag box. The reason why I'm doing this here is because I need to remove the hash at the back of each of the hashtags and place a comma in front of them. When you do that, once you copy all of them and you paste it in your tag box, it will everything will just arrange on its own. But if you copy it like this and paste in your tag box, it's going to appear as a single entity. But if we do it the other way, it will appear as different entity on its own. Let me show you an example of what I'm saying. Now, I've copied it. Okay, let me show you. If I go back to my tag now and I come here, once I paste it, you see that all my hashtags are just in one box. Can you see this? All the hashtags are here. So this is not how we are going to do it. You can see where it says, you can see beneath here, it says enter a comma after each tag. Okay, so that's how we're going to do. So I'm going to close this. So I'm going to put a comma in front of each of them and remove the hash at the back of them. Okay, so as you can see, I've removed the hash at the back and placed a comma in front of them. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to copy all of them and then paste on my tag box. So you're going to paste them here. I'm pasting them here. Now you can see that they are all in different entities instead of the way we did it before. Okay, so now your tags are ready. And then the next thing, you're going to choose your video language is already automatically chosen. Now your title and description language, you're going to choose your title and description language. For mine, it's English. So I'm going to look for English. Sorry, just going to click on English and that is it. Here is caption certification. I'm going to show you where we are going to automate our caption and everything. So you move on. You can see here it says to manage other languages, go to subtitles. We're going to do all of that. Recording date and location. This one is optional. If you want to put your recording date, you're going to include it here. Your video location, you can include it here as well. Then again, the next thing, this license, you're going to leave this on, allow embedding, publish to subscriptions, feed and notify subscribers. You're going to click on this box. Yes. Now, short remix, as a growing channel, you're going to allow people to be able to remix your videos into shorts. So you're going to click on allow. Do not restrict this part. And then here is category. You're going to include the category of your video. What kind of niche are you doing? This is where you are going to indicate it. So you can click on this. Mine is how to and style. Okay, for yours, if it's comedy, you're going to click comedy. If it's education, you go. If it's entertainment, any of these are the categories. Okay, so you're going to choose from these categories your kind of niche. That is what you're going to click on. Comments and ratings. Comments, yes. Allow comments. Do not turn off comments. Allow comments on. Moderation, yes. Just leave it as basic. Sort by the top. You know, yes. If you want the comments you want to appear first, if it's the top comment or the newest comment. Now it says, show how many viewers like this video. Yes, if you want to see the number of viewers that likes your video, you're going to click on this box. But if you don't, you untick. Okay, then moving on, we're going to the next part, which is end screen. Now we're going to choose the end screen for our videos. This end screen usually appears at the last 20 seconds of your video. Okay, so
I have a very detailed video on how to set up your end screen and cards. You can also watch the video right here on how to set your end screen. Okay, so we're going to choose our end screen. Here, YouTube will suggest the videos for you. Yes, YouTube is going to suggest your videos. But if you don't want these videos that YouTube has suggested for you, all you need to do is come here. Here, you can see it says how to... Okay, here is, you're going to select the best video for you. Here you see, you can see it says most recent upload. If you want your most recent upload to show on your end screen, you are going to click here. If you want best for viewers, if you click best for viewers, YouTube is automatically going to include the thumbnail that is best for your viewers from your channel. Okay, but if you don't want that, you can choose the video that you want on the thumbnail. When you choose, click here, you are going to choose the video. Here it was automatically ticked. Okay, so you're going to choose which of the video you want to appear. Okay, I'm going to choose this one. You can see that's automatically selected. Then for this second one, I'm going to choose another video. Okay, you can choose this one to appear as my end screens. So you can see that both videos that I chose are now my end screen. Then when you have successfully selected the end screen you want, you're going to click save. Mind you, if you are placing your end screen, make sure you place one above this way. The way I did this, place one here. You can also place another one here and another one at the bottom. Okay, you can place it here. Do not place at this part. Do not place here. I'll explain to you the reason why we don't place thumbnail here, because this is where our card is going to be displayed. Okay, so now our thumbnails has been placed successfully. Then you're going to click on save. Make sure you click this save. If you don't click on this save, whatever settings you have done here for your end screen is not going to be saved. Click on save. Now, our end screen has been saved. Okay? Then now we are going to choose our cards. We have successfully chosen our end screen and cards. You come to cards. You're going to select your cards for your video. Okay? So, most of the times, I choose 5 cards. I choose 4 videos and 1 playlist. Okay? So now I chose 2 videos for my end screen. Those 2 videos I chose for my end screen, I'm not going to include them again in my tag. I'm going to choose an entirely different video. All of this is just for your viewers to have quick access to your other videos. Okay? Alright, moving on. Okay, so the first video I chose, I'm going to edit that, sorry. Okay, so I'm going to include this. Now you can see how to set up YouTube description the right way. Okay, that's my first card. Now it has appeared here. This is it. This is the card here. This box you're seeing, this white box you're seeing, this is my first card. Okay, so you can see it up here. You can see it up here. Now I'm going to go to card again, choose another video. You can decide to choose a video from your channel or from someone else's channel. If you are choosing from your channel, sorry, let me edit this. If you are choosing from your channel, you're going to search here. This is where you're going to search it. On this box here. Or if you are choosing from another person's channel, this is where you are going to search the video. Okay, so I'm looking for another video to put as my card. Okay, I'm going to choose this. Okay, top view AI avatar. When you choose the video, you're going to scroll down to place where the card is going to be. This is the card, so I'm moving it here. Okay, I'm moving it here. All right, so now I've included 2 videos. I'm going to put a playlist at the middle. Then you come here, where this place here, you're going to click here again, click on card. I'm going to choose playlist next. Okay, so my playlist, I'm going to choose support system as my playlist to be displayed there. When you choose your playlist, you're going to scroll down again. It has been added here. Okay, I'm just going to move it. So I've successfully added all 5 cards to my video. So when my video plays up to 3 minutes, you're going to see the next card. When it plays up to 6 minutes, you see the next card. 9 minutes, just like that. So when you have done all of this, you're going to click on save. Click on save. And then my cards are fully saved. So you can see it's fully saved. Now, for your subtitles, how to set your subtitles. I made a video as well on how to set your subtitles and how you can translate your subtitles to other languages. Do endeavor to watch that video as well. Please, if you have not subscribed to my channel, this is the right time for you to subscribe. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video, and also hit the notification bell so that you can always get notified whenever I upload new video. Okay, so with this, you have been able to successfully set up your video for upload. And then the very last thing you are going to do after all of these settings is to click on save here. If you don't click on this save, everything that we have done here is totally a waste. Okay, so you are, make sure you click on save, and when you save that video, you are done with everything that you need to set up your video for upload. So I'm going to click on save. Then my video has been successfully saved. Okay, so with this we come to the end of this video. I hope you found it interesting. Let us know in the comment section if you did yours and how it worked for you. Okay, so until I see you again in my next video, bye.